So, finish on the creams and the blues for now. I've reapplied the base for the skin and the hair, just in preparation for the matte varnish. I also noticed I've been holding it too long on a part on the leg. And just before we reapply the matte varnish, I've just got some really watered down Xandri dust and just, I mean, literally tapped it over just so I could hide that kind of imperfection. Right, so I've applied the matte acrylic again, just to kind of seal everything in. See, it's probably brought everything up, but I will add some of the highlights again once I've put things together. I now want to work on the skin. Apologies off camera, I did recoat with Bugman's Glow just to bring it back down to a matte effect. And then I used Reichland Flesh Shade. I was just debating if that was the shade I wanted to use, but because in a lot of the images, he seems to have quite dark tones, as I mentioned from the light, quite bright sort light source coming from above. So I did decide to go for Reichland Flesh Shade. I did one coat to the arms, pretty much neck and back. And I did pretty much end up adding a second coat onto the face just because I didn't feel like it was bringing out some of those darker details. So now, just wet my brush, and I've got relatively decent sized brush now. I'm just getting my Bugman's Glow. Again, I want to really get this watery. I work on the arms first just because I just want to bring them up. So for those are just nice big swipes. Said before, just find those pieces of muscle and just help create a gradient. It'll look much like there's much more of a contrast at the moment. But as we go along, we'll bring that down. As I said, I do want particularly this side. Well, I'm going to go all round, and then once we start going up with colours, we'll start picking out this side a bit more. Now for the face, I do again want to do the same thing. So here, just because of the way I want to do it, I do as a one-on-one add a watery coat first. So it is very difficult sometimes to make sure you're getting the right color on. So you do in some ways just need to go with your gut. As you can see, I'm going under the eye but leaving a bit of shadow for the eyelid. I know there's gonna be a bit of light that's gonna hit this side of his eye as well. Then want to come down over the side of his face, probably up to this sort of point around his hair. I'm gonna go through this whole process. So I went over it probably once and a half with the watered down Bugman's Glow. I'm now just with a much less watered down, so probably how most people normally paint. Starting to apply some slightly more prominent lines just to make sure it's thick. I'm also just trying to focus it more on the right hand side just because that's the side we're gonna start to build up. So again, you can probably see hopefully the sort of transition you're getting between the shaded, the light coat, and now a much thicker coat. Okay, so I'm finished with just putting that watered Bugman's Glow on top of the Bugman's Glow with the Reichland Flesh Shade, and I hope you can see essentially just bringing out those additional tones. Again, I've got the light right kind of on it, so it's again very obvious now. But the closer you get it, the more subtle you can bring that transition, the better. I'm now going to get the it's there somewhere, Cadian Flesh Tone. And just make sure that's very watered down. And I'm now going to just start building this up, particularly on the right hand side. I'm going to put more effort in, well, more coverage on. I said I put this on in sort of streaks just so I can figure out how I want it to sit. even now. It's not like I have a process, it's more a case of just fill it in, let the first layer dry, and figure out how I want to build that color up. And I always know that the highest bits are going to be the main part, but then as I paint that, I find sometimes it just doesn't look right, so they're just other bits you're going to want to fill in as well. Like you do the fingers, but then a lot of time the knuckles are going to really need an extra shine just above it. This part for me, because this is where I want to really kind of bring the color of the skin up, does take quite a while. But as I said, if you just keep going, same again with the face, just to give you some slight view on that. I want to just touch upon, not necessarily the highest areas, but let's say 50% of the highest area. So again, still going to be a big part of his skin. I've now added in the Acadian flesh tone just to add a bit more variance to the skin. Before I go up to keys to their flesh, I think it's probably safer to start working on the eyes. So I've just added in the, well, sorry, I've added in the Flayed One Flesh on the eyes, slight highlight of Flayed One Flesh and white over the top, and then filled in the eye colour with McRae Blue. So I've now got Out Off Guard Blue and Calgar Blue, and I'm going to use the exact same approach that I did with Yoda, just to fill in the colour just inside of that darker blue. Slightly different to the Yoda. I filled it in because I realised how far he's looking in one direction. You can see he's pretty much all the way to one side. So I filled it in with the Out Off Guard Blue, all to one side, trying to leave that little gap just on the left, or his left. And now I've taken the Calgar Blue, and I'm just trying to sort of dab it in. As I said, one, it will highlight the colour, but it comes back to that theory that if you do it, it will just add a little bit of a two-tone as it dries. So, as I said, I do want him to have a little bit of a, how do I say it, sort of shine in his eye. So I'm going to kind of put it up in the top right where I intend to add the white dot near his, his pupil. Kind of get the idea. Trying to now position the camera in a slightly different way towards me. So you can see that's my chest. Just so that as I am painting the eye, I can try and do it properly. Position it to my chest, probably as close as I can get it without, you know, making this hand difficult. And now I believe I have just a lot more control. If I go for this eye, it's a bit easier. Just slowly dab that in. Now I'll work around that, and this is where you just need to maneuver. But as I said, having it really close to your chest and kind of doing the Tyrannosaurus Rex approach, I think is really, really effective when you're trying to get these little dots around the eyes. I wasn't happy with how dark the blue was. I wanted to have like a really blue. So I've taken some of the Calgar Blue, really watered down, and I've just dropped it in again into that just offset into the corners. I'm hoping once it dry, it'll have a bit more transition, but most importantly, bring the colour up. After that, I'll reapply the black. As you can see, I've added in the back pupil and that little white dot to simulate the light. You've got relatively that dark blue to the light blue. I've tried to centralize the lighter blue into this bottom corner. Same again. So my camera's going to struggle here. Into this corner as well. And now I just want to, just taking a bit of brown. Because I'm finished with the eyes now. I will probably add some shade in a moment. But I just find as I'm working around the eyes, I actually like to have the eyebrows in. So just with a brush that's really isn't twisted to a point, just start very lightly brushing a brown, or know, whatever color the hair you want it to be, over the space that you want the eyebrow to be. I find personally, if you can just see some flesh underneath, and I really do mean like just, it creates a much more realistic eyebrow. As you can see there, it's not some solid, thick brown line across his head. So I'm going to do the other one as well, and have a think about how I want to finish off the eyes. So now I just want to neaten up the eyes a little bit. So before I do any painting over it, I've just chosen Reichlin Flesh Shade. And so I'm going to get that camera. And same as I did with the Collier Green Shade with Yoda. I just want to go around the edges again of the eye, just to one, bring out the depth, but also figure out where I want to clean up. You see there's quite a bit there that I now need to fix, a little bit on that side. So I let the shade dry, and of course it's just I had to neaten up a little bit again on the white and Flavon Flesh. And now that's dried, I can just go round with my Cadian Flesh Tone, very hardly watered down if I'm honest. Whilst I was waiting, my brush has dried a bit, so it'll be a bit more watered down now. And just want to start fixing up around the eye. Okay, this is too watered down for what I'm trying to do. So you definitely don't want at any point suddenly getting a pooling in the eye. You want it to really stick to the model. I appreciate it might be a bit thicker, but if you get the right consistency, you can just cover those overlap of the eye painting with one coat, as you can hopefully see now. Always remember when you're looking from this point to then a bit more, try and get on the underside of the lid, because obviously that's where your most of your paint overlaps, and it's actually the bit that makes the eyes, in my opinion, look the most ridiculous. It's when you can kind of see the colour kind of following on onto the skin. You really do want to get it as close to the eye as possible without getting it on that line from the shade. Hopefully you can see that one there. Right, so I did touch up a little bit of the Cadian Flesh Tone just whilst I was fixing the eyes, but now, and that's the good thing I guess about dealing with really watery paints, is wherever you go you can always just add a very quick layer. So once again, particularly for this key serve, the highest layer, I want it to be very watery. Starting again, now really just that final point to bring out some extra detail. Then, as with everything, the final stage for me will be go back down to that Cadian Flesh Tone and just providing a light wash over everything, just to bring it, well, bring this color down and bring the base Bugman's Glow up. As I said, I didn't want him to be as dark skin, but I do want all the variation with some deeper recesses. Again, so I want the light to come from above, so I'll come around this way. And this is why I have it so watery at this point, because I think I've mentioned it before, I'm not always sure. So if I add it on light in this place I think it will be, I can come back when it's dry and decide, is there any sort of additional areas I need to kind of stretch it into? Because I nearly always fail on the first attempt. You can kind of get the idea now. I just want to bring some of these additional colors out, but as I mentioned, I want the lightest colors to be on the right hand side. So on the face, now really starting to pick out the detail Set on the right, so I want to just transition and just finish just before the previous one. Now really I'm just going to focus with much lighter brush strokes only on the right hand side. I really think that'll just help bring out some of the shade. Once that then dries, I can kind of see how I can then, I guess, shade them into the Acadian flesh tone. So as you can see, I've kind of built up the cheek, I wish I knew the names of face things, the line between the mouth and the cheeks. I want to probably add a little bit more under the eye, this bit under the brow, this side of the chin, again not getting all of what I've covered before. I think this cheek's going to be a bit wider. But I'll go round, and once it's dry, I can then really kind of assess and see how much more I want to add. Idea though, I'm even on the nearly third coat on the face at least, and it still is looking kind of tacky. So it's just worth noting that, especially at least the first two layers, you aren't getting anything. You're just kind of slowly building up that shape, getting an idea. And now, as I put it on, I'm starting to see I'm getting a bit more coverage. As I mentioned, it's the same consistency as before, but I can just start to have a bit more control. And as I said, if you're someone that knows exactly where you're painting and how to create this effect in a much easier way, crack on, but I very much doubt you'd watch this. So yeah, for me it's just a way to really, really slowly build up. You just have to have confidence in those first two steps that you're just picking out shapes that are relevant to the face and relevant to your direction of light travel. Happy with the keys to the flesh. I've gone to a slightly thicker consistency, so you just get that deeper coat. And I hope you can see, I'm starting to actually try and add in some actual brush strokes now, just to kind of give it a bit more of an effect. You don't want to add this in a kind of solid consistency, because otherwise it will just cover sort of shading you've made before. But if you can just get some relevant lines in, very thin ones, really just to help pick out those final points. You can see it's starting to look quite overly bright, I'd say. Some people quite like this effect, but I prefer just to bring it down a tiny bit. So once I finish the arms, I'm going to run over with the Acadian flesh tone very watered down. So I've been all around the skin now, and I am really happy with the gradients. Particularly, the problem I find is with arms, or where you have arguably bigger panels, that you then end up with these quite starker transitions, particularly with Bugman's Glow. I am a fan of Citadel paints, but I do find the transition of Bugman's Glow to Acadian flesh tone is a bit too much. Some people might mix and then just kind of create a five shade transition. But what I like to do, particularly because a lot of these lines are quite stark, they're quite all over the place, and maybe some people like that, if you do, stop here. But I actually really like to mute these now. So I'll start on the arm. As you can see, this is the Acadian flesh tone, really watered down. Sometimes I'll go over it twice if I don't feel like it's brought the Bugman's Glow up. I mean, that's probably the primary aim. But at the same time, I find in doing so, you bring everything else together. Yeah, this will definitely need a second coat. So I'm going to go around. I will probably swap out for a smaller brush, but I'm still going to do the face, but I just want to be very, very careful around the eye. So I'll come back in a moment. So I'm on the second coat, and it's just hopefully you can see how it's starting to tone everything down. I just wanted to highlight that now that I'm on this sort of second tone, particularly on the face, I've done, just a quick show you, I've just been coating this side, maybe a bit more there, up to here. But as I said, I wanted there to be some more shade on this side. So once I'm done, then wash my brush off completely. I mean, pretty much 90%, and even then it was pretty much all water. And then I've continued to push that out. So it won't make hardly any difference to the colour on this side of the model, but it will ensure there is no stark line whilst it's essentially being washed. So once that's done, I think I think I might add one more because I'm worried this Keystone Flesh is too bright for a model where I still think I want him to look like he's in a swamp. I appreciate I mentioned over and over that the picture was very, very bright. But at the same time, looking at it now, and at the end of the day, it's going to be on my shelf, I think it's just a bit too much. Again, just going slowly and slowly, I've started to realise that even though it's coming across, I felt these hands were just too dark. Sorry, I don't want to let that being a pull. I'll just keep on going across, making sure, just brightening up the front of this model, and as it goes back, creating a bit of a transition. So as this dries, it will be again nearly non-existent, but it can still create quite stark lines if you let it dry in a line. So see, again, I've just washed off my brush. I just want to kind of let it, I guess, transition to nothing. Okay. So I think I'm happy with the face now. Put a bit more effort in on the forehead and the eye. Made sure I shaded a lot more so it's coming in from one side. Debating the arm, maybe putting one more, at least from the top, coming down. I think it needs a bit of a transition downwards. But other than that, I'm pretty happy with the eye. I just wanted to do the typical thing where I should have done it on the previous layer, but it's to add a little bit of red onto the lips. In the picture I've got, or the pictures I've seen, he does seem to have quite like plump red lips, but I hate that look. It just doesn't work for me. I don't care if, even if it's a woman with red lips, I don't want them to look over the top. Unless of course it's meant to be lipstick, then you'd go all out. But for here, I'm watering down to a point I don't even know if it will make much of a difference. I just want to make sure I'm getting that shape. Yeah, let's type it more in there. If you can see, it is possibly just giving it a little bit of a red tint, but I hope that once it dries, it's going to be nearly non-noticeable. I think it's for me just to say that I've painted the lips, but I really don't like them to have a even mildly stark contrast in colour. The only thing I find that you should do, awkward angle for me, but it's get across this top part of the lip. So ideally, just creating a bit of that shape back. Remembering it comes up and sort of down and then up again on the lip. I don't know how well I did that on the camera, but I'm gonna go off and try and sort of just touch that up properly. Hopefully you can see just a very, very fractionate red tinge to the lips. I've touched around. I feel like lips might be a bit darker than I had planned, but I'm again going to put the model together and then make a decision from there. Do I kind of want to add a bit of a highlight, bring it down with something else, or am I happy? So overall, I think I'm happy with this model head to toe. Maybe not the boots just yet. I still need to work on the silver bits. But the final thing I am going to do is just add one more of this Cadian flesh tone water. I don't want to call it a shade or anything. It is essentially probably 80 parts water, possibly even more. Obviously, then the other part is Cadian flesh tone. And I'm just brushing this over. I actually think I may have made a slightly thicker consistency here. So I'm going to go over this part, just not the top, but just further down. It's pretty much now in my brush, it's 95% plus water. Make sure that pool doesn't exist. And then I just want to a bit more and work it around the front. As I said, I just want to make sure that top part that lines with his face, it has that similar brightness. Same again with the water. I just want to kind of bring it around the back so that shade transitions out. So I'll see how that dries. I'm hoping that will add a bit more just transition on the arm. I'm pretty happy with Luke. I just feel like the last thing we need to do is touch upon the hair. Typically, and I can't believe I haven't noticed throughout this entire process, but it actually turns out when I check the original file that his hair, you can see there, kind of actually has a much longer flick. So for the sake of transparency, I'm going to quickly paint this tiny little piece brown first, just so when once I glue it on, it'll be much easier and I won't have to then go behind the flick to get that colour on. I'll do a little bit of sanding, and then once I'm at that point, I'll come back. Okay, as a quick recap, I've just stuck the piece on after a little bit of sanding, filled with wood filler, and sanded it back down again. And I think that just, it looks a lot better. I think I'm quite lucky because it's probably made the painting process much easier by not having it there, but I wouldn't recommend trying to snap it off for the process. So now I'm just going to go around over the whole thing, so all of the hair, with the cheap brown again. No point on painting the hair, maybe it's just a personal thing, but I always get a really tiny brush and just go around these edges because I find you really do want to get around those little hair flicks as much as possible. But once I've covered this line, I just grab my big brush and go all over. It's been very neat recently, but I just like the idea of just showing everything we've just been working with for this one project. As mentioned, I have now added in the hairpiece. I think there is a slight line that you can see there, but I'm hoping as I dry brush and add some additional colour in, I should be able to mask that up. So, I'm quite happy with the job. What I'm now going to do is I'm going to go over the entirety of the hair with Agrax Earthshade, again being quite, I say heavy, but just loose on the back, but very, very, very neat on the front. So I've pretty much gone around all of it with my bigger brush. Sorry, it's in the pot now. I've now got a much smaller brush, and I want to just make sure that everywhere I've covered is just pulled right to the front, and I'm just covering that lip between the skin and the hair. I find it just ensures there's a nice line between the two. Last point, so I've just been going around the hair and I'm happy now, but what I was doing is, with a slightly more watered down Agrax Earthshade, I was just picking out skin points that I felt were particularly shadowed, even on the lighter side, i.e. see the hair would be really covering this. So I've just been using that very, very lightly, and in a non, kind of making sure the line isn't straight, so really just tapping it over, just trying to help build up a bit of a shade on the skin in between this hair. And I've done that as well on just a few other bits where I feel like there should be a bit more shade on the skin. So just whilst the hair is drying, I have added one very, very thin layer of Cadian Flesh Tone over just the top of where the lip ends, purely because I felt it was a bit too dark, a transition from where the lip was to the skin, and I feel like that's where the light would hit. So just wanted to highlight that. And also, whilst the skin is drying, I'm getting my good old Ard Coat, which I believe is just a gloss varnish. I want to get enough of it on my brush. And also, if you ever worry that your white dot is a bit too big or bright, I find this brings it down a little, which is nice. Well, I think it's nice. Okay, and just make sure that you have got all of it covered. I find if you try and do two layers, can sometimes not look as good. So there, just got the eyes covered. I think the lip transition looks better now. I'm just going to give it probably a few more minutes just to really make sure the hair dries, and we'll come back. Whilst that was all drying, I really dedicated my time to crafting this little tool, and it's just blue tack. I'm just, and to clarify, I'm only pushing it a little bit on the hand just to make sure it stays, and just covering up some of the key areas of the face. This is purely risk management. As I said, a good, still dry, because I do like to build up any dry brush. But you can just see, just rushing over. I want to start in the area where I expect the light source to be strongest. I still want to go over most of the hair for this, other than some of the shortest bits. And of course, when I get to the face, or anywhere near the face, I want to be extremely, extremely delicate. So you can see I'm already nearly out on the brush, but I still want to keep on going. Because you can hopefully see, sorry, I'm trying to get some light on that. It is still adding that colour. So that's why if you start off strong, you can then work your way down as your brush, I guess, has less and less paint on it. So I guess that's okay for the moment for this side. I said I'll go around, I'll come back, and I probably will need two or three coats. Okay, so I've gone around with the first coat of Scrag Brown for the dry brush. I just wanted to highlight that although I mentioned I went across the top, I've also gone around the edges as well. I think it's quite nice when you have not just the light hitting from the top, but hitting from two tones. But I wasn't happy with the amount of brown, particularly around sort of the crown of his head, so I have just been going around with arguably a second or just over a second dry brush. So I'm now on the third dry brush. I give it as much time to dry in between, and I also make sure it really is to a point where there's nothing on there. I think it's what enables you to kind of build up these more gradual transitions with one color. The last point, especially on this last final dry brush, I've been trying to focus it down this line here, and I've been just bringing out the color a bit more across the right. So I hope that just helps with the gradient. The thing I've always had with, I guess, dry brushing is sometimes you just don't get as stark a line as you'd like. So once again, this is watered down, I'd say probably 50-50. I'm just, with a very small brush, highlighting some of those lines that I really think, one, probably haven't been caught as well with the dry brush, and two, just should be more prominent. So they look quite stark when you first put them on, but as it dries, I think it just really helps, well, yeah, just highlight the dry brush itself. So hopefully you see what I'm doing. I think that just needs to go a bit higher because again the light source is coming from this side. But just this last point, you can see, oh sorry, you can probably see dry brush really hasn't gone into this area. I don't want to go all the way down because I want to kind of still retain that shade, but it's really just a case of figuring out parts that you don't think the dry brush has really kind of brought out. And if you do this with a very watery color, as I am now, as it dries, it will slowly disappear. Well, it'll just not be as strong. And then you can just go over with a second coat, a little bit more centralized to really bring it out. So I'm gonna go around with the first one, then I'll come back. So I'm happy with where this sort of layering on top has gone. See how it's just brought out that dry brush so it's a bit more prominent. What I did is I think I went a bit too strong on the front tail, and I think it's because of the imperfection was showing up. So I just had some Agrax Earthshade, I mean very watered down, and I just wanted to touch upon some of those parts just to bring it down again. But whilst I had it, and this is the main reason why I've started recording again, is with, as said, pretty much nothing on the brush. So, yeah, I mean, I don't know if you can see this, but I mean, there's literally nothing there. I'm just drawing a line under the eyebrow. I felt like it lacked that slight bit of shade. So the problem when you do this, if you don't do it very neatly, you'll just stain the skin and it can look a bit ridiculous. But I find if you can just create a very thin line, I do mean to a point where it's better to paint over the eyebrow with it than it's than you want to paint on the skin. Sorry, need a bigger workspace. So just underneath, I think particularly on this side. So yeah, it's on the camera. Particularly on this side, because it's going to be under the hair. I want to get that over. Yeah, probably see the first time. Okay, and just underneath. So I'm going through this whole thing. I just think this one, it's one of those that, particularly with eyebrows, I think if you just get that tiny line of shade, you probably hardly even see it there, but I think it really helps. And one final bit, going back on what I was saying before. I did want to add just a tiny, tiny bit of highlight to the to this top part of his hair. Just going back again to the picture. I know obviously my paint isn't as my painting isn't as good enough to get to, you know, lifelike quality, but it's nice to have something to work towards. So I'm using Deathclaw Brown. And the only reason for this is the only light brown that I have. I kind of tinkered around and I think it reasonably works. So I just want to test it. It's extremely, extremely dry brush. I don't want to get any smudges off on this. But I'm just testing on my hand. And now just want to brush over this front part. And I hope you can see just creating the tiniest of color changes. And that's all I really want. I don't want to overdo it with some sort of, you know, insane light source on the hair. But I do think it's nice if you can just add that slight difference in colour. Again, I think I just want to bring it down over this front as well. And possibly just a bit on this side. Sorry. And I hope you can see it's just brought in a bit of the colour and changed the tone a bit. Okay, so I think I'm happy with where Luke is. So other than the boots that could possibly do with a bit of touching up, I'm going to wait for until I put him on the base. I have, however, just got some that same black dipping formula and watered it down. I think essentially like a black wash. Probably a bit thicker if I'm honest. I just want to go around these silver bits. Particularly the buckle. Let's find silver creates more shade, or should look like it's got more shade around it. I find black around silver looks nicer. I don't want it to entirely destroy that. So I want to go around all these silver bits, and just another point. I just noticed that the neck isn't very clean, so I'm going to go into the edges with the black. Possibly once or twice, just to make sure I feel like I've got a nice separation of colour. And then once that's dried, I will neaten up the cream. But again, I'd prefer to get it on the cream than I would on the flesh. Okay, so I'll just come back in a moment. The black shade has dried now. I've just got some, pretty extremely watered down metallic. I find that if I just want to bring it up slightly, I would use something that was probably a bit too bright as a base. So I just want to touch upon the top parts of these buckles, I guess. Another point, I don't know if it's just me, but finger to thumb, or just finger on the model, I do find it does add a lot of pressure at times, so I do have to take breaks, but for me it's the only way I can get like a much better control, kind of like putting your finger there and then playing a bit of chopsticks. So, final piece, this one I do just want to add a bit more highlight right at that top. Just because I think it looks cool. I don't. Across. So, until I have this guy on the base, I think I'm done with Luke. Done with Yoda as well, just pop him on the back. I think at the moment the light works together. And even though I didn't account for the painting in the quiff, I mean, it's always going to create a natural shade.